Okay, we've extracted the old door. Generally, the motor connector is broken, which makes it fairly easy to get the door out. If that connector still is partially in place, you're going to have to cut along the edge of that and just cut the axle, the backbone of the old door, and it'll pull out. It's fairly tight to wrangle that in and out. This one we were able to get out fairly easily and put the new door in. But you may end up making a few additional cuts along the side to make just a little more room to squeeze it out. This is the new door installed. The door will fit in and then the axle inserts from the outside, just like we're seeing there. And check that it's going to move up and down freely, and this one's doing exactly what we want it to do. So we'll go ahead and reinstall the motor, and I'll show you moving it up and down, and then we'll seal the cut. Okay, we've got the new door installed and the motor in place, if you can see it there. And before we seal up the cut, I just wanted to show you how that door fits in. It is a little tricky to get everything aligned and the axle inserted and the motor attached, so expect a little frustration, but it's not difficult. So you can now see the door move, and it will move down, and that's under motor control, and then when you release it, it'll go back to the center position, and everything is moving correctly and sealing within inside the box. So we'll seal up the cut and put it all back together. Okay, this is the finished product. You can see basically just a mass of metal duct tape. So this doesn't really look very good. It's not a very clean fix. However, very few people are going to open your glove box and look at it. So neatness doesn't count. When I reinserted the cutout piece, you can see a little screw that we took out on the bottom. I put that back in place. That holds the patch in the right general area. And I use hot glue, just a hot glue gun is really nice to sort of tack weld the small piece in place, and that glue dries very rapidly. It will make a nice solid patch and then just seal all of the seams with the metal duct tape. At this point, the repair has been completed. We have the motor in, the wiring hooked up. We've replaced the blend door. We're going to put the car all back together. I'm not going to bore you with having to watch that on the video. If you could get it apart, we're assuming you can get it back together. But the fix is fairly straightforward, fairly easy. You can count on a few scrapes. I'll show you a picture. This is great. I'll show you what my hand looks like after doing this repair. There are a lot of sharp metal edges, you can avoid that by either wearing gloves or covering some of the sharp edges with duct tape. I did neither of those. The repair is in a very confined area. It will take a little frustration to get it done, but once you get to this point, it's very satisfying to have 100% functional AC in.